The embattled president of Venezuela, Nicolas Maduro, says he is ending diplomatic relationship with the United States. This comes just hours after President Trump officially recognized an opposition leader as the legitimate president of Venezuela, and it comes after days of violent protests in the country. So let's first begin in Caracas with Stefano Pozzebon covering all of this. And Stefano, can you give us a little bit of context as to why Maduro would have said this, and where would these diplomats go?
Yes, exactly, Brooke. We've seen history rolling up in front of our eyes. Earlier today, the president of the National Assembly here in Caracas, the president of Parliament, president of Congress of Venezuela, swore himself in as an interim president with the support of the United States of America and of many other countries around the world, including Canada, Paraguay. These triggered an escalating reaction, and Nicolas Maduro has announced just minutes ago that he is ending all political and diplomatic relationships with the US, and he's giving them 72 hours for the consular staff to leave Caracas, or as early as possible. Really, situation escalating dramatically. We have seen clashes of words played in front of our eyes for the past 2 weeks. The Vice President of the United States, Mike Pence, spoke with Juan Guaido, the President of the Venezuelan National Assembly, here to reiterate his support, to say that the United States are on the side of the anti-Maduro opposition here. And now we're seeing the reaction from Nicolas Maduro, who quite literally said, "Get out of Venezuela, Brooke."
Okay, Stefano, thank you so much. And so, Boris, to you, covering the White House, you just said, the White House's position supporting the anti-Maduro opposition. Why?
Hey there, Brooke. Well, yeah, there's a number of reasons why the White House has laid out a rhetoric escalation over the past several days, indicating that this move might be made today. And the president took the step shortly after National Assembly leader Juan Guaido swore himself in as the legitimate president of Venezuela. He now has some 30 to 45 days to start new elections in that country. From what we understand, the White House was expecting that several other countries, not only Latin American countries, but European nations, would also recognize him as Venezuela's legitimate leader. The big question now with Maduro breaking off relations with the United States is what happens specifically at the pump with oil. These two nations for years have tossed back and forth rhetorical grenades at each other, but they've maintained a relationship when it comes to the trade of petroleum, of gasoline, and other related products. In this case, the White House had considered previously installing a full-fledged ban on Venezuelan oil. They ultimately backed away from it because of the potential economic ramifications for the United States oil market. Clearly, if that step ultimately is taken by Maduro, it would mean that Americans would feel the pain at the pump. We should point out, earlier today, the White House held a call with some NSC officials, and we were told on background by one of them that the White House has, quote, barely scratched the surface of what the United States can do to inflict pain upon Maduro economically. Exactly what that means going from here, we don't know yet. I've already reached out to the White House to find out exactly what they plan to do after Maduro's declaration. They've yet to get back to me, Brooke.
And the diplomats, Michelle Kaczynski, you cover the State Department for us, and if they have 72 hours to get out, how? Yeah. Where do they go? What's the story there?
Well, they're going to have to leave. I mean, this reaction came swiftly and harshly, as we might expect from Maduro after the U.S. declared him not the legitimate leader of Venezuela. Mm-hmm. So we've seen these kinds of expulsions before. I mean, we saw them just in the past year between the U.S. and Russia with, your diplomats need to leave by Friday, and then, well, your diplomats need to do the same thing. But this was tit for tat, and those could be replaced. But this is Maduro ending political and diplomatic relations with the United States. Here's what he said during his speech just this afternoon. The imperial government of the United States is leading a coup attempt against us in order to install a puppet presidency that they can control in Venezuela. I have decided to break all political and diplomatic relations with the U.S. Get out, leave Venezuela. We have our dignity, damn it. What we're waiting for now is to hear from the State Department on their response to this, and also logistically during this shutdown, how they're going to get everybody out in a hurry, and what the next steps are. As you heard others say, you know, today on this call, the White House insists that this is just the beginning of the pressure that they can put on Maduro, but he's clearly wasted no time in exacting some of his revenge on the United States, Brooke. Mm.